My name is Dr. Thakral, and I'm born and raised in Washington, D.C. I'm the first physician in my family, and so I've had a great sense of understanding when patients need to have a little bit more attention, a little bit more understanding of what conditions they have and how to treat them. What separates the HealthLink Medical Center from a lot of other physicians' offices is the amount of time we spend with the patient. A lot of our consultations involve educating patients on what exists and what treatment options can really help them. As an osteopathic physician, coming to HealthLink was almost a no-brainer because it really falls into my philosophy of the body can heal itself, it just needs a boost. And this is where regenerative medicine has really come in. The difference between platelet-rich plasma and stem cells is really that the platelets are releasing growth factors that most of the research now is showing can help with chronic tendon and ligament injuries. The stem cells, on the other hand, are the cells in our body that can help differentiate into other cells. Stem cells have the ability to heal and to repair more of the severe type conditions, such as severe osteoarthritis or partial to complete tears, whether it's in the shoulder at the rotator cuff or the knee. The Regenix model looks at the body as a whole. So we not only treat the osteoarthritis, but we treat the supporting structures lending to that particular joint. So for example, osteoarthritis typically involves a narrowing of a joint. When you have narrowing of a joint, that usually leads to laxity of the tendons and ligaments around that joint. So the Regenix model actually helps treat those supporting structures to not only facilitate the joint, but also to help supplement the stem cell injections that we use to treat the underlying osteoarthritis. I had a really interesting patient where she had two chronic rotator cuff tears, and both of them were equally painful for her. And she ended up going through an operation on one side and having a stem cell injection on the other side. What was interesting is approximately 6 months after the stem cell injection, she had complained of no pain and was dramatically better than the side that was operated on. And it was really thrilling to hear that a patient can benefit from a stem cell injection. And she was back to doing things that were basic to everyday life, which is opening the cupboards or playing with her grandchildren. And to see that we can help a patient get back their quality of life without using scalpels, without using stitches, without having a major operation, it was the most rewarding experience I've gone through.